Hey guys, welcome to Vlogmas Day 1. It's currently noon. I woke up this morning, had a couple of cups of coffee, and I started watching this new like Netflix documentary. I'll show you guys what it is later. If you like murder mystery stuff like that, which I think everybody does at this point, then you need to watch this show. So I just got done filming. I'm doing a foundation first impression on a drugstore foundation and concealer. So they're both really affordable. But yeah, so today's Vlogmas. I really enjoyed doing Vlogmas last year, so I wanted to do it again this year just to let you know how I do Vlogmas. So instead of posting at the end of each day, I like to film 3 days and then post the morning of the fourth day. So I'm going to vlog December 1st, December 2nd, and December 3rd, and then I edit like on the third night, and then I put it up in the morning of day 4. Hopefully that makes sense. So I'll have a total of 8 different vlogs, but the most exciting thing this time around doing Vlogmas is I'm going to be doing giveaways at the end of each Vlogmas. So does that make sense? I don't know. So that means on when this vlog right here goes live after the first 3 days, the morning of December 4th, this will post and there'll be a giveaway at the end of the vlog. So make sure that you stay tuned. You can enter. I don't even care if you want to enter every single giveaway. So we'll just do it like that. If you want to enter it and you win, then you have a possibility of winning all 8 if you would like to. I have a lot of good stuff set aside for giveaways. I'll probably put those together tomorrow during Vlogmas. So I'll give you guys like a sneaky peek of what you're going to possibly win for all 8 giveaways. I have a lot of good stuff, not gonna lie. So anyways, so we already decorated for Christmas when we got back from Vegas. We went to Vegas for Thanksgiving and then we decorated that Sunday. So what would that be, like the 25th or something, 24th, 25th? So we already decorated and then I made a list of stuff that I still need. So I need like 5 or 6 different pictures. I drank way too much coffee today. I'm like in the shakes. So anyways, we're gonna go to TJ Maxx, Home Goods, Hobby Lobby, like those places, and I'll probably get some lunch because I haven't eaten yet and I'm gonna bring you guys. So yeah, so we're gonna do that today and then I'll let you guys see how I put everything up and let you know where I got everything from last year that I already have up for Christmas as well. Can I talk about this lip kit again, even though I talked about it in my Vegas vlog? But like this new Kylie lip kit in the shade Kylie is so good. Like, you guys, I got back on Black Friday and bought 2 backups. Like, it's so good. I know. Normally, I don't rock the bra straps out. Don't worry, I'm putting on a sweatshirt. But it gets really hot in here when I film. So yeah, I need to wear this type of stuff. So anyways, I'll see you guys here in a little bit. So I thought it might be cool during Vlogmas if I do like outfit of the days, which this is obviously not too exciting of an outfit of the day, but I'm wearing Lululemon leggings. They're high-waisted. They're my favorite. The only thing that I don't like is they don't have the cell phone holder. Then I have a pair of Nikes. And then I'm wearing just like a Forever 21 tank top. And then this hoodie is actually from Balboa Island, Newport Beach. Super cute. Do you want to talk shit to the people of Vlogmas?
She always says, shut up! And then I know I have at least 3 or 4 more I'm readys before she's actually ready. She just said her third one and now we're actually ready. Huh. Look who's right again.
You know I run shit.
Uh-huh.
I'm in my mom's car, vroom vroom. Going on over here. We're on our way to Victoria Gardens in Rancho Cucamonga.
Oh, Jesus.
And this car just pulled out right in front of a semi truck. That could have been very bad. But anyway, so we're on our way to Victoria Gardens and guess what today is? I saw it on my email yesterday, but today is a National Candle Day? I don't know. But Bath & Body Works is selling their candles today for $8.95. Sorry about that. The lighting was horrible and you couldn't even see my face there for a second, but I think I have a good 30 seconds before it does it again. But anyways, Bath & Body Works is doing their candle sale. I think the last time I bought from the candle sale, they were only $8, so they raised the prices. So anyways, are you excited to go to the giant candle sale? It was crazy last time I went. People were like, the line, I think we stood in line for like 45 minutes, which is so stupid. But like, people were like shoving people kind of and like taking candles, and it was insane.
Baby Make Music, how you feel about that?
Cheesecake Factory and gets drunk. The food was good though. I always get the same thing, chicken and biscuits. And then I made him get the orange chicken because he always gets the burrito, and I was like, you're not getting that this time. Sweater that was at that store and now it's gone. Oh, you're taking me by Zara, so nice.
The road's closed.
My favorite. Even though we were just here like 5 days ago. Remember? We decided against Zara because it's all the same stuff from like 2 weeks ago or a week ago. Then we tried to go to Starbucks, but there was way too many people, so we decided against that too. Now we're going to Ulta. So I think we're gonna hit up Home Goods first, then Michael's. Is right next door, so we'll go there next. Oh my god, this is so cute. Yeah, we don't drink tea.
Thank you.
HomeGoods, we didn't find anything. Getting flashbacks of this time last year for Vlogmas when we went to HomeGoods and didn't find anything. But I was really banking on it for pillows, so now I don't know where to look for Christmas pillows. So now we're gonna go into Michael's and see. Look on the wall, or is that too much? I think those wings are too much. I like that picture too, but that's too big. I'm starting to think we waited too long last minute. We didn't find anything in there either. I found one picture, but we weren't gonna wait in line for one picture. But all the Christmas stuff at Michael's is 70% off, so more to me.
I don't know, I kinda wanna drink from somewhere.
I think we're gonna go to TJ Maxx and then try to find a Hobby Lobby down here somewhere. Hobby Lobby is my last resort though, so we'll see. Got home and we kinda adopted these little tiny babies outside. They won't let me touch them. I really want to though, but they won't, but they're so cute. This orange one right here is a boy. And then I think the little black one is a girl. There's actually an evil one that bit me, which is not here right now, but. We saw them when they were little tiny kittens, but they won't let me touch them. And I'm so sad because they look so sweet. So I put a blanket out there for them to lay on and I feed them every single day. But they're so sweet, but they won't let me touch them. And then there's one right there. Probably won't be able to see it, but it's back there, a little blob. It bit me once. Aren't they sweet? Hi, babies. Are you hungry? Do you want some food? Huh? Do you want some food? So that little chunky orange one's a boy, and I'm pretty sure the little skinny black one is a girl. They're so sweet. Here. So I finally, if you remember last year's Vlogmas, I had like really bad yellow lighting in my dining room and I switched to the, I think it's natural daylight or whatever. I want to switch all the bulbs out of my entire house to this like white daylight because look how good the lighting is. Normally it would be like the color of the Christmas tree and like that is so not flattering. So I need to do that. I need to remember to do that anyways. But yeah, we just got here. It's 7:30, so I just reheated up my food from Cheesecake Factory, so I'm gonna eat that real quick, and then I'm gonna show you guys everything that we bought. So I'm making Jaden hold the camera so I can show you guys everything that we got. So this is the only Christmas pillow that I found, and I'm gonna put it on like this couch right here. So this is like a three-seater couch, and they have like a two-seater couch here. So I figured I'll just put this big old long Christmas one because honestly, this is the only one that I liked. And this was, I think it was $30. This was $30 from TJ Maxx. I think it's gorgeous. Like if you can see, there's like little rhinestones and beads and stuff all over it. It's so pretty. Marsh wants to say hi. Say hi, Marshmallow. Say hello. Did you miss me? Look, say hi. So we ended up going to two different TJ Maxx's because I don't know if I just waited. I feel like I bought all my Christmas decorations this time last year, so I don't know what's going on, but like everything was like gone. So we found one sign from TJ Maxx. This was $9.99. This is like the cutest thing I could find. So we got this. And then I'm gonna come back to TJ Maxx because I got some coats, but I wanna show you guys what they look like on, so I had to take this off. So I'll show you the rest of the stuff first. So then we went over to Kirkland's, and this is the second time I've ever been into a Kirkland's, but it kind of reminds me of Pier 1, but like a little bit cheaper. And they're having like a customer appreciation weekend or something, so everything in the store is 20% off.
So if you were thinking, you should go. I'm honestly done buying Christmas presents, but I saw this for my aunt. I thought she would really like it. So this is what it looks like. I would take it out of the box and show you, but just trust me. Like, they had them on display and they look so cute. So you could put like a little, it says it's a pre-lit cardinal Christmas vase. So cute, and it was $19.99. Then I found this super cute sign. It says baby, it's cold outside, and it has some little like metal mittens right there. And this was $16.99, but 20% off. And then I have another bag from Kirkland's. I got this sign right here. It says, Holy Night. It's like one of those like painted signs, and this was $12.99. And then the last thing I got from Kirkland's, I normally would never spend this much on a picture painting or whatever, but I thought it was really pretty. And this was $34.99. Look how pretty that is. I love this. We stopped by Ulta. Not for me though, but I did get some stuff. But we went there because we needed to get Frank's little
goddaughter
a Christmas gift. And I guess she likes makeup now. So we got her one of those little like makeup cases, because she's like 11 or 12, so I wasn't gonna, or we weren't gonna buy her, you know, like super expensive makeup. So they had these little cases on sale for $20, and I think this would be perfect for like young girls, because the makeup, it's the Ulta brand makeup, and Ulta brand makeup is not bad. So here, you open it up and then you get a row of blushes, highlighters, bronzers. You get a whole row of matte and shimmer eyeshadows. And then when you open it completely up, you get a whole nother row of matte and shimmer eyeshadows. And you have some liquid lipsticks, some lip glosses. And at the very bottom, you have blending sponges, you have brushes and lip liners and eyeliners. Got the same one for his sister. It's just a different color. And then he told me to pick some stuff out. So I got another one of these because this is my favorite to wear during the cold months, especially around Christmas. It's the Philosophy Fresh Cream Lotion. It smells like Mrs. Fields. Oh my God, go smell this and buy it. And then I saw this Morphe palette, and this is the Morphe 9N About Last Night palette, and it looked really pretty. So this is what it looks like. It's really small. It's like the size of my hand. Look at these colors. Aren't these so pretty? It kind of reminds me of a Kylie like holiday palette. I think it's gonna be really pretty. I wanna start buying stuff from Lancome and Estee Lauder. What's the other? And Elizabeth Arden, because those brands have been around forever, so they have to be doing something right, right? So I went over to the Lancome counter and they have these new powders. So this is the Lancome Long Time No Shine Translucent Loose Powder, and then they have a deep shade. So as far as I know, there's only two different shades. This translucent shade and then the deep shade. It was a little pricey, but I mean, Lancome always is. But look at this container. You get 15 grams, and I touched it and it felt so smooth and like butter, so I wanted to try it out. And then we went to H&M, as you guys saw, and I'm like really into sweaters. Like, that's all I plan on wearing the entire time we're back for Christmas. So I found this. I've been buying like crop sweaters like crazy because I think they'd be really cute with my like high-waisted Lululemon leggings or high-waisted jeans. So I found this white one, and it's kind of like that fuzzy. Marsh! Here, get that. Marsh is trying to bury her food with all the bags. Jaden, can you pull that away? No, you don't need to do that. So I got a size medium because I figured it would be cropped enough. I don't know if it'll be long enough to tuck into the front of a jeans or something, but this was $12.99. I got all these on sale except for that one, but that one was only $12.99, so it's kind of on sale, right? Then I found this really pretty pink one, and it's kind of longer, but it's really low cut in the front, so I thought it'd be cute to wear like a white bralette underneath that you could like see, like a strappy harness one. And this one was on sale for $15. Then I got this kind of baby pink cardigan. I got it in a size medium and it was $20. It's kind of shorter with like more bellowy. I don't know what I'm saying, but this is what it looks like. They had like two whole racks of sweaters on sale. So if you need them, go check out H&M. Then I got this one. This was $10 and I got a size small. It's just a turquoise color. I think turquoise looks really pretty with like blonde hair. And the last sweater I got was this kind of like navy, it's like a cobalt, I think. Blue color, this was $13.99, I got a size small. And then up close it has like white kind of stitching in it. I wanna wear this for like a, I wanna do a blue snowflake eye tutorial for like the winter and then wear this. Thanks. And then I just went up to the men's section and I wanted to get some plain color t-shirts to go with those sweaters, especially like the cardigans. So I just got a men's black t-shirt. This was $6.99 and I got a size small. And then I got the same t-shirt in white. And then I saw these socks up front, and I normally don't buy a lot of socks, but I thought these were super cute. And they like go up to your ankle, but look, it's got like sparklies. This was a pack of five for $12.99. Sorry, I need to take off my jacket so I can show you. I almost bought this coat when we were at Macy's, but it was $150, but it was one of those like super soft like teddy bear coats. Thankfully I didn't. I found these and I got three of these for less than the price of that one. Look at this jacket. This was $25. So it's that pretty like kind of like teddy bear brown on the outside and then the cream on the inside, and it's soft inside and outside. Look how cute this is. I got a large. I wanted to get a medium, but they didn't have any, and I didn't want the small. So this is what it looks like. It's kind of long. And then it has a hood. How cute is this? Like, and it's like big enough to fit a sweater underneath, I think. Even though I don't know if you'd want to, because this is really warm. But how freaking cute is this? So cute. And I got this one, and I was watching Black Friday hauls on YouTube, and a lot of people were showing something that looked like this from Victoria's Secret, and they said it was $100, and I was like, you know. So I found like the exact same thing, same color and everything from TJ Maxx. It's from the brand Thread Supply, and this was $25 too. Like, they have the exact same thing at Victoria's Secret for $100, and the only difference is the little like dog thing. So if you've wanted that one, but the inside isn't the soft material, but I'm okay with that. Ooh. This is thick. Like, I don't even think I would need to wear a coat. So warm, so squishy. So I thought I got a medium, but I actually got a large in this, but that's okay. I don't mind. You guys will see them at some point in my Vlogmas, but pants in the pajama aisle. So they're like that teddy bear soft material. They were $12.99. I got a medium, and this is the front, and look at the back. Super cute. And then I found this foundation and I opened it to make sure it wasn't used, and it wasn't. This is from Elizabeth Arden. It was $7.99, and this is the Flawless Finish Perfectly Nude Makeup SPF of 15. I got the shade Warm Sun Beige 06. I feel like nobody talks about Elizabeth Arden. I like the packaging. It kind of reminds me of like Dior or like Tom Ford, and it does have a pump, so it looks like the color match will be okay. It looks like it's a little pink, but. And then we saw this when we were checking out, and it's just a notepad, and it says Hello Gorgeous and has lipsticks down here, and it has a lipstick pen. Oh, and this was $2.90. And then this is the last super fuzzy thing I got. I haven't worn a vest in like 15 years, but I'm a sucker for this like material. Oh, so I got a medium, and this was $19.99. I thought it would look cute with like a plaid long sleeve shirt. Did she just steal a bag? Oh my God, give this. Marsh! Did you get stuck?
She can't hear me because she's deaf, but did you get stuck in the bag? Come here. Oh, look, you're a superhero. You're a superhero, Marshmallow. Marshy. You got stuck in the bag? You did. What's she doing, Hazel? Is Sissy being crazy? Like she doesn't even care. Marsh, you're stealing the show.
A thin sweater maybe, or a long sleeve plaid shirt, and then this on top. Cause like, I get cold in the winter, but if I could keep the center of me warm, but have like my arms out so I'm not like overheated, I will take that. But this is super freaking cute. So yeah, you guys need to go to TJ Maxx. Seriously, out of everything I showed you, well, H&M, if you need sweaters, go there because they have two racks of clearance sale items. But like, for real, if you're by a TJ Maxx, go in there and check out this like fuzzy furry stuff. Oh, look, and it has zippers. So definitely let me know if you guys go to TJ Maxx and find any of that cute, like super soft, fluffy clothing. Oh my gosh, I'm a sucker for anything that's glitter, sequins, or fluffy soft. And now I'm gonna wait for Frank to get out of the shower and then we're gonna hang up all the Christmas stuff. So I'm gonna show you guys that. So instead of showing you guys all the Christmas decorations tonight, I think I'm gonna wait till the morning when it's light outside so you can actually see everything, because it's kind of dark in my house. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and end this first day of Vlogmas now, because I'm just gonna take a shower and then we're gonna watch probably Netflix. But I'll put a clip in of that Netflix documentary that I was telling you guys about this morning, so you can watch it too. This is what the documentary is called. The first one's intense. We're already on season two, but you should definitely check it out if you like these murder documentaries. It's not really a murder mystery. I don't know. So tomorrow we're gonna go to Six Flags Magic Mountain, so that'll be fun. I'm gonna bring you guys along for that, and then I'll show you the Christmas decor as well. So I will see you guys in the morning. Frank taught Marsh a new trick. Hi, Marsh. So cute. Hey guys, welcome to Vlogmas Day 2. Today is December 2nd. I just got done filming. I'm doing another foundation first impression. Well, it's not really a first impression because I did use this foundation a couple years ago, but I haven't touched it since. So I think from now on, I'm just going to do my foundation first impressions on the weekends, because that's when I'm out like running around, like doing running errands and doing God knows what. And then save during the week for like makeup tutorials and hauls and stuff like that. So plus this only takes me like 30-45 minutes to film minus the check-in. So I'm like super quick when I do foundation first impressions. But what do you guys think? It's the L'Oreal Lumi foundation. I think it looks pretty good. And then I'm wearing Dose of Color Stone on the lips. I haven't worn this in so long. So I'm gonna go ahead and do something with my hair because it's a mess. So I need to like re-straighten my bangs and put those down, and then I think I'm just gonna leave my hair up because I just don't feel like dealing with it. And then I need to pick out something warm to wear because we're gonna go to Six Flags Magic Mountain today, and it's supposed to be like 60, and by like 4 o'clock I think it said it was supposed to be down into like the 50s. I'm gonna look again. Oh, okay, so right now it says it's 57, and then, so right now it's 57, it's supposed to get up to 60 at 2, and then by the time we leave it's going to be 49. I know what you're thinking. Probably wherever you live, it's probably like 20 degrees. Like, I'm from Kansas, so I totally understand negative degree weather. I should not be complaining about 49 degrees. And when we first moved to California, I remember it being in the 40s or 50s, and I'm still wearing a t-shirt and shorts, you know? And then everybody around here is wearing like winter coats and UGG boots. And like now I feel like since I've been here for 6 years, I've gotten used to the weather. And believe it or not, like in the 40s here in California is still chilly. I mean, it's not like shiver chilly, but it's still chilly. So I'm gonna go ahead and get changed. I'll show you guys what I decided to wear, and I will see you guys here in a second. Mind my bed, I have laundry to do, but look, Hazel found a little sleeping spot. Oh, did you find a hiding spot, Haze? Hazel. He's so cute. You go night-night, okay? Bye-bye. Hazel. You're so cute. You and your little house. Your house made out of pillows, your pillow house. He's so cute, Mama. He's so cute. So this is my perfume collection. This is Crystal Gardenia from Kim Kardashian. It smells so good. It's one of my favorites. This is Givenchy Play. I really like this too. This is the Kim Kardashian body perfume. And to be honest, if I would have smelt it before I bought it, I wouldn't have bought it. Like, I don't like it at all. Then I have the YSL Black Opium, which I think went bad, but when I first got it, it smelled so good. This is the Gucci Guilty, but she said this has like cherry notes in it. This is one of my favorites as well. This is my all-time favorite. This is Givenchy, like, Ange, oh, Demon, I don't know. But this smells like so like sexy. I don't know, I love it. And then, of course, I have Lucky Perfume because this is what I wore in high school. And then I bought all these Britney Spears perfumes because they're my favorite. This is Circus, I really like it. This is Private Show. I have no idea what this is called. I don't really like that one. This is Britney Spears Curious. This one, I can't remember what this one's called either, but I kind of like it. I think it's just Fantasy. I don't really like it though. This one, on the other hand, this is Midnight Fantasy. This is Frank's favorite. It smells so good. And then we have this Fantasy one. I don't really like this one either. So then I have like the Fresh Cream one, which I love to wear during the winter. I also have the body spray because it smells like cookies and I just really like the scent of it. So I don't know which one I want to wear today. Which perfume should I wear? What perfume should I wear?
What
perfume?
Yeah, Britney Spears Midnight.
I think I'm gonna wear the Circus Britney Spears. Bangs. Oh, it's that one right here. So I'm gonna wear this one. I just douse myself in all my perfumes. I even hairsprayed this down. I don't understand. But it's gonna get messed up on the rides anyways. Oh my gosh, this is such a mess. I need to do laundry.
Let me go ahead and die real quick, because I know that's what you want.
Let's do a poll in the comments below. How old is too old to play video games?
I got an American field.
Could you just let me play?
No.
You just gonna quit?
No.
You should wear spandex all the time.
Oh, I think I'm gonna look good.
Okay, so while I'm waiting for him, I'm gonna show you guys where I put that Christmas stuff. So I put these two pictures here, and then I put this one here, but I think we need to move this one over a little bit. So maybe we'll do that tonight. And then up the stairs, I put that angel picture that I'm obsessed with. I wish it was a little bit bigger, but maybe I can find, I don't know, something to put around it. And then we got this pillow, which is perfect. Sorry, I need to fix that cushion, but it looks really good because it's long enough. I did get on tjmaxx.com last night and I found some other snowflake pillows, so hopefully Frank will let me buy them and I could put them with this. But I'm obsessed with this pillow. It's so gorgeous. And the only thing we couldn't find yesterday and we looked everywhere was a table runner to go on this table right here. Because I feel like it just looks really bare. So I'm going to just kind of like stop looking. If I happen to find one, I find one. But maybe next year. So I guess I'm just going to do my OOTD with Frank and Jaden right directly behind me. So I'm wearing this long sleeve shirt. This is from, how do you say this again? Isleta? Isleta?
Yeah,
Isleta. Casino. It's in New Mexico. We stopped there when we drove back from Kansas this summer. So I just got a long sleeve shirt. And then this, if you can find these at Costco, you should totally snap them up. They're in the women's section. But if you can see, like, the soft furry thing is all the way through the jacket, but it's not in the sleeves. But it does have a hood and it's super cute. There's like five different colors of this, and it has some pockets, just really comfy. And then I'm wearing Lululemon leggings and my Kylie Puma shoes, which I think are kind of ugly, but they're really comfortable. So this is my Vlogmas day 2 OOTD. Would you like to tell them what you're wearing?
Yep.
So Frank over here is wearing a NASA shirt that we got from Marshalls.
Yes, and some spandex.
And some spandex. And bare feet. Mm. Very fashionable. What are you wearing, Jaden? Jaden is too cool for school now. If you guys remember him from Vlogmas last year, he had such a cute little kid voice and he was all cute and nice, and now he hates me. He is wearing a shirt from Forever 21, and Frank has a matching one. Then he's wearing some Forever 21 black jeans and some Vans. Jaden, OOTD.
Want to? I hope not. Cut the tree off a little bit. Definitely tell by my hair that I just got back from a theme park. Ugh, like my bangs. Ugh, gross. So, we just ate some McDonald's. Tomorrow I'm gonna try to eat a little bit more healthier starting tomorrow until Christmas time when we go back to Kansas, because I've been eating like crap. So I kinda wanna get back to just drinking water, no pop, no chips, no candy. We'll see.
So I think I'm just gonna go ahead and wrap up Vlogmas Day 2 here. The only thing I'm gonna do is, well, right now I'm still filming a foundation first impression, so I need to keep this on for about another hour. So I'm gonna take a shower, take off my makeup, put on some comfy clothes, probably watch some TV and then go to bed. And then tomorrow I will see you guys bright and early for Vlogmas Day 3. All I'm doing tomorrow is editing. And my camera died. It said battery exhausted to be exact, so I had to charge it for a little bit, but I don't even remember what I was saying. But I think I was saying I would see you guys tomorrow. I'm literally just gonna be editing all day tomorrow, and I need to clean up the house because the internet people are coming. Thank God, because our internet sucks. But I want to show you guys this cute like sweatshirt I got from Holiday in the Park. Like everywhere I go, theme park, vacation, whatever, I always have to get a shirt or a sweatshirt or something. I don't know why, but I have to. This is what it looks like. It's nothing too special, but I like it. I'll probably end up wearing it tomorrow. It's kind of expensive though, $30. I don't know. Yeah. But anywho, I hope you guys had a wonderful Sunday, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye. Why are you doing that to my chair? Marsh! I have obviously looked better. Good morning, guys. Good morning, guys. This is Vlogmas Day 3. So at the end of today, I will be posting Vlogmas Day 1, 2, and 3 tomorrow morning on December 4th. But yeah, you wanna see what I've been doing every single morning since we've put this tree up? I have been chasing this one, Hazelnut, does not bother anything throughout the entire year except she likes to sit underneath the tree and eat it. Then we have Marsh, who likes to go underneath there and rip open all the presents. She successfully has ripped open the entire back part of this giant present. Sissy is crazy, isn't she? Huh? Is she crazy? Is she crazy, Hazel? You're such a pretty girl. Yes. She is Devil Kitty. So, I told you guys I was gonna do, I guess I probably should have fixed my hair. But I told you guys I would do like outfit of the days. So this is gonna be my outfit for the day. And I have no shame. I got this sweatshirt yesterday at Magic Mountain. It's super comfy. I got a medium. I feel like I wish I would have got a large just so it was like even baggier, but meh, whatever. Then I'm wearing a tank top. I just conveniently match a tank top from Forever 21, those cheap like dollar ones. And then I'm wearing these Christmas pants that I actually got last year during Vlogmas from TJ Maxx. Their pajama pants are so soft, and these are like $10. And then I'm wearing these. I got these from Boohoo for like under $10. So this is my cozy, comfy Christmas OOTD for December 3rd. Also, I've been really, really liking this candle from Bath & Body Works. It's called Campsite Coffee. I'm almost out of it. I really like to light this like first thing in the morning while I drink my coffee because it makes my house smell like Starbucks. So I've been using this in the morning, and then as soon as I'm done drinking coffee, I light my favorite candle of all time, which is the winter candle from Bath & Body Works. This is my favorite scent, literally. If I could burn it all year round, I would. It smells like, I don't know, it smells like winter, snow, pine, Kansas winters to me. So I like that I can bring Kansas in a candle to California. So I really like to burn this during the day and especially at night. And then my favorite, well, winter is my favorite scent, but my second favorite scent for Christmas is the Fresh Balsam Wallflower. So I just changed the one in the living room to that, and then I got this Christmas tree thing from Bath & Body Works, I think a couple years ago. Then I also have one of my guest
bathroom.
And this is my coffee bar. We put this together last year during Vlogmas, and for Halloween, I found Halloween pictures to hang right there and right there and right there, just to kind of tie in some Halloween into the kitchen. And I wanted Christmas signs, and I literally could not find them anywhere, so I don't have any Christmas signs this year. Thumbs down. But I like to know what kind of coffee people drink, so I thought I would show you what kind of coffee I drink. So I buy these little refillable coffee grind cup things from Walmart. And then I always switch out my coffee cups with Christmas cups, but clearly some of these are still in the dishwasher. But this is my all-time favorite. It is so good. If you have this, I find mine at Target or Vaughn's. I've yet to see it in Kansas, so I don't know if it's just like a California thing or what, but this is so good. Seriously, it'll probably be my favorite coffee for life. I don't know. You guys need. But I got this one from Cracker Barrel last time we went, and I thought I would really like it, but it's kind of just like I would take it or leave it. Like, this is my number one still. But this is okay. So this is what I drink. This is actually what I'm going to be drinking today because I poured it in our little coffee cup. So this is where I keep my coffee. So this one right here is actually the Starbucks holiday one. If you don't like coffee, you know what I mean? That just tastes like a coffee bean. Like, I don't know, I can't explain it. This is so like coffee-ish. It's like too much for me. This is where I keep, so I just know because we put that little sticker on there. And then this is where I keep the one from Cracker Barrel. And then here is where I keep my fake sugar, so my Splenda. But I haven't really been liking Splenda lately. So I went back to sweet and low packets. I got this little thing off Amazon. Today I wanna keep my like sugar intake down. So I'm just gonna be using sweet and low and half and half. Normally I drink whole whipping cream or something like that, but I have half and half. So I'm gonna do half and half and sweet and low and my coffee. But when I really wanna enjoy my coffee, I drink this in it. It's from Walmart, it's so good. Like, I'm so obsessed with it that I ordered a case off of walmart.com. So I got 6 of these and I think I'm only down to 1 left. So this is my favorite. It's so good. I always do like 3 tablespoons of this and then 2 sweet and lows, and that's like my perfect cup of coffee. And then if I want to keep my sugar intake down some more, I use this one, which I don't really like, so I kind of hide it back there. But this is my favorite. Then I also found this off of Amazon, and this is good for iced coffee, but it's not good for hot coffee. I don't know why, but it just doesn't dissolve right in hot coffee. We actually got this from TJ Maxx, I think, and we have yet to try it, so I don't know. And then this is okay too for, I guess, a no sugar vanilla replacement. And then this I thought would be really good, and I don't like it. It's the white chocolate caramel. I don't know. I feel like I'm really picky when it comes to coffee. Not picky, like, so I'm not uber picky. Like, I'm not, I don't know if you guys could hear that, but that was Marsh ripping open all the presents. So I'm not like super picky when it comes to coffee. Like, when I go to Starbucks, I'm not like, oh, can I have a pump of sugar-free vanilla and a half a pump of caramel and then five drops of blah, blah, blah. Like, I'm not like that. Like, if I go to Starbucks, I just get the chestnut praline, which is my favorite during the holidays. And really, I don't go to Starbucks during the year unless they have their holiday drinks. I'm not like an avid Starbucks drinker. But if I do get anything other than that, I just get like a regular like vanilla iced coffee. Like, I'm super basic when it comes to that. And I used to get the chai lattes a lot too, but I don't really get those anymore either. But I like Dunkin' Donuts. I don't know what it is, but I like the orange and pink straws, and I just like the atmosphere of Dunkin' Donuts more than Starbucks, I think. I don't know, but if I go there, I get like a cold brew with, I think it's sugar-free vanilla cream. It's something like that, or almond milk. I can't remember exactly how I get it, and then I bring it home and I put in like Splenda or something like that. But yeah, that's my coffee. Take in 3 packets of Sweet and Low. I like to put in the fake sugar first, so it'll kind of like dissolve in the coffee before I put something cold in it. And then I'm using this half and half. I never know how much to pour in there. That looks good enough to me. Yeah? Are you my big girl? You wanna say hi? Let go of the thing. Are you mommy's pretty girl? You are, but you are a terror, little deaf cat. You don't want me to hold you? Let me put you down? Okay, I will. Okay, I put you down. I just got a PR package from Buxom. I already like peeked and I think I know what it is. I think it's the new highlighting palette that they created with Shay Mitchell. I love Buxom. I have loved Buxom since I first got out of high. Oh my God, I can't. So this is the Divine Goddess Luminizing Highlighter Palette. It says, I absolutely love how the unique gel formula sets to a silky powder, helping to create the perfect radiant glow. Hope you all enjoy it. Love, Shay Mitchell. I saw this on their Instagram and I was like, oh my God, I need it. So pretty. Ooh, it does look like a cream. So it does feel like a cream. These are the 3 shades. Hopefully you can see. So these are the swatches. Ooh, they feel so nice. What'd they say, cream to powder? Sets to a silky powder. So pretty. Yay. Thank you, Buxom, for sending that over. I cannot wait to put it on my face. Here's a little behind the scenes of my giveaways. I have this entire basket filled to the top of awesome makeup. We have some name brand stuff in here. We have some skincare. We have some blushes. We have eyeshadow palettes. Oh my gosh, you guys. We have brushes in here. We have tools, mascaras, like everything. There's also some skincare in this big old thing. There's some more in this tub. I feel like I should look more presentable for my giveaways, but I'm gonna go through and make 8 piles right now, and when I'm done with the giveaway for today, I'm gonna show you guys and then I will tell you guys how to enter and all that stuff. Here are my giveaway piles. So this will be today's giveaway. I will show you guys the details here in a second. Then we have a second pile, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, 7, and 8. So this is today's Vlogmas day 1 through 3 giveaway. So you're gonna be getting an Eco Tools brush set and travel case, some deluxe tweezers, an Estate liquid lipstick, then a Note blush, this Morphe palette right here, a MAC lipstick, a Tarte Pro Glow Liquid Highlighter, some face masks. Then you're gonna be getting 2 of the Buxom Pillow Pout lipsticks, an Alamar eyeshadow palette, a Pretty Vulgar eyeliner, a Smashbox metallic liquid lip, some Urban Decay lashes. This is the Butter London Double Decker Mascara, and you're gonna be getting this Banish Acne Skincare System. The Wet n Wild Not a Basic Peach Palette, which is one of my favorite drugstore eyeshadow palettes. Okay, so now I'm gonna tell you guys how to enter my giveaway. I just want you to subscribe to my YouTube channel because that's only fair, right? And then I want you to go ahead and follow me on Instagram. I will put my Instagram handle on the screen right now. So that way, if you do win, I can just DM you on there, and that just seems like the easiest way to get a hold of you guys, and then you can send me over your address and I can send you out your goodies. So to enter, just go ahead and leave a comment below. That's all you have to do, but make sure you put your Instagram handle in there as well so I can get a hold of you. Yeah, if you want to leave a nice comment, if you don't want to leave a comment, if you just want to tell me how your day is, you don't have to tell me anything. You can just leave your Instagram name. That is fine as well. Feel free to enter all 8 giveaways. If you win more than once, more power to you. That's more goodies for you. I'm not going to limit anything, although this is going to be just... Also, the only downside of this giveaway is it's not going to be international, so please only enter if you are in the United States. Maybe next Vlogmas I will be able to send out giveaways internationally, but this time I'm not going to be able to, so I'm so sorry. But yay, I'm so excited. If you guys win, please tag me in any pictures that you take or any post or whatever so I could see you with your goodies. I'm so excited to be giving back to you guys. So, yeah. Again, I will be putting all the directions on how to enter in the description box below if you want to go check that out. Again, just so you can see it. Like, I myself am a visual person, so I don't really pay attention when people talk to me. I have to, like, see it. So, I will be putting all the directions and rules and stuff, like, in the description box just in case. Oh, my face is so red right now. I don't know what's going on. I guess I'm just so excited to handle these giveaways. I don't even know. I forgot to let you guys know when I'm going to end the giveaway. So this video, when you see it, will be December 4th. So I'm going to let this giveaway run for 3 days, and then I will announce the winner on 4th, 5th, the morning of December 7th, when my next, like, round of Vlogmas goes up, because I am vlogging 3 days, posting on the morning of day 4. So then I'll be vlogging December 4th, 5th, 6th, posting the morning of December 7th. So the morning of December 7th is when I will choose the winner for this giveaway for Vlogmas day 1 through 3.